In this tutorial, we're going to quickly go over how to import existing transcripts into Transcriptive, like if you have an existing text or SRT file, or a transcript created with Adobe's text panel. This is going to be using Transcriptive 3.1.3. If you have an older version of Transcriptive, you'll want to download this version from our website, digitalanarchy.com. To import a transcript, first select the clip in your project panel you want to import the transcript to and turn on clip mode, or if it's a transcript for a sequence, turn clip mode off and open the sequence. You should see the name of your clip or sequence here and then click import. This opens the import dialog. Select the file type you're importing. Plain text, SRT, and VTT captions are all supported, and I'm going to select plain text and then click here to select the file. This menu attempts to auto-detect any existing timecode and speakers in your file. Speakers are going to be put into this speaker menu where you can see them and delete any that aren't actually speakers. Combine lines into paragraphs, if it's off, will import the file in the same format that the text file is already in. If you set it to on, it will combine any lines that have the same speaker into a paragraph. So if you're importing an SRT file, for example, where everything's broken into a ton of lines, you can turn this on to create larger paragraphs. Timing per word is an option that will have Transcriptive guess the location for each specific word. This text file has timecode for each paragraph, but not for each word. So if this is set to off, Transcriptive shows the current paragraph during playback.
All right, cool. So you're out to the side, which looks great. I'd actually like to see your donut.
And if it's set to on, it shows the approximate location of each word, although these word locations aren't going to be 100% accurate. Only the first word in each paragraph is, since that's the timecode the transcript had when we imported it.
All right, cool. So you're out to the side, which looks great.
To sync the transcript with the clip or sequence 100% word for word, you can click transcribe and then select alignment, which is a free offline process that analyzes the audio and the text and then syncs them up. This has no language selection and only works with English transcripts. It takes some processing time, but once it's done, each word in the transcript will be in sync with where that word is spoken.
All right, cool. So you're out to the side, which looks great. I'd actually like to see your donut go just a little bit farther.
You can also import a text file with no timecode at all and then run an alignment. So if you're planning on aligning your transcript, they don't need to have any timecode. We'll link to our video on alignment in the description if you want to learn more about how that works. If your transcripts do have timecode, the import menu will try to detect it. The timecode dropdown gives you an idea of what formats we support and should automatically change to the correct one once you select your file. Same for timecode format and speaker format. Under time at the bottom, you can see what Transcriptive is detecting for the first timestamp in your transcript and the last timestamp in your transcript. And then this shows the starting time code of your clip or sequence. This should all be detected automatically, so if it looks right, just click import to finish importing the transcript. If you need to change the time code of the transcript to match the clip or sequence you're importing to, check edit start time and enter the actual start time of your clip or sequence. Then enter how much you're adding to the already existing timestamps. For example, if my text transcript starts at 0, but I need to import it to a sequence that starts at 1 hour, I'll get an error, and then I'll need to offset these time codes by checking edit start time, Transcriptive already detected that my sequence starts at 1 hour, and then set the offset to 1 hour to add 1 hour to all the timestamps in this transcript. Checking subtract offset subtracts 1 hour from all the timestamps in the transcript, so you can import a transcript to a clip or sequence, even if it was transcribed using a different start time. Normally though, your transcripts are just going to match the thing you're importing to, and that should all be auto-detected, and you can just select the file and click import. If you have a transcript in Premiere's text panel in the Transcript tab, you can click the top right menu and select Export Text File. And this is a format we support importing in the latest version of Transcriptive. You can import it into Transcriptive if you want to use it in clip mode or export to different caption formats, for example, just by using import and then select the text file. You can also import the text file and automatically run an alignment to sync it word for word by selecting Import Adobe Transcript and then selecting the text file. You can also select an SRT file that was created from the Adobe Captions panel. and it will automatically import the file and start the alignment. Once that's done, the transcript will be synced word for word in Transcriptive. If you have any questions or want a free 2-week trial of Transcriptive, send us an email at cs@digitalanarchy.com.